My interest in textiles started on a reflection that was done really long time ago, like for an architecture thesis project. I was making a project for the African burial ground in Lower Manhattan, and had wanted to use cloth, kente cloth, actually in different cloth, and was trying to communicate through meaning in the textile. The work that I can do is really to bring together, for example, textile design, where you're really talking about stitch geometries and their qualities and characteristics with an idea for adding function to that textile through electronics or using the actual qualities of the kind of fibers in the textile or the geometry of the textile to do some kind of thing that you couldn't get it to do otherwise. When we say robots, we get this like frightening image of a tin can and like this really kind of harsh technology, but in fact, it could be a really squishy little stuffed animal that you can play with. And that animal can help teach an autistic child about emotions and behaviors of live things. Communication is linked to so much in terms of how we understand the world that if we could begin to understand how these pieces are linked in our brain, we can begin to understand, oh, well, someone that might be having a speech pattern problem or a language impairment or forgets language can be assisted with touch or feeling something or squishing something or seeing something move. Those were experiments in shape-changing textiles. And the point of that was really to get them to be like animal reactions, to see if people could understand what was communicated from a shape-changing texture. So you could potentially communicate to someone without an animal there to see if they would understand that as being frightened or something else. To me, that gets me really excited as well. Like how so much of this technology is interesting because of what it tells us about us humans. So not so much what it can do, but also what it tells us about ourselves, to me, is really fascinating.